The Autobot Decepticon war continues to rage in this third installment of the Transformers franchise from Michael Bay and DreamWorks.
Most of the cast from Revenge of the Fallen returned, with the most notable exception of Megan Fox, whose character apparently breaks up with Sam, again portrayed by Shia LaBeouf, after the second film. But Sam is given a new love interest in the form of Victoria's Secret model Rosie Huntington-Whiteley.
You love it, don't you? I'm just your American boy toy.
Although an official reason for Fox's absence from this film hasn't been explained, her dismissal did take place after describing director Michael Bay as a, quote, Hitler to work for. This time, the story opens up back on Cybertron as the Autobot-Decepticon war rages in full force. We see a ship attempting to escape the battle, only to be damaged and sent out of control into deep space, eventually crashing into our moon. We then learn that our lunar landing back in the summer of 69 was in reality a public cover-up to investigate and salvage the crashed ship.
No signs of life or movement, Control.
Now it's at this point that I'm not going to reveal any more of the story, so no spoiler alerts from me this week.
I can't promise anyone a ride home, but if you're with me, the world needs you now.
Visually, this movie is everything you can expect from a Transformers movie. 300 flood-damaged cars were used and destroyed in it. The CGI effects of the robots has improved, in my opinion, since the first movie, making them very believable. As someone who thinks that Hollywood is overusing the 3D technology on movies, where it's just not necessary, I have to say that it adds an outstanding level to this movie. As for the acting, most is well done, with the most notable exception being the performance of Rosie Huntington-Whiteley.
This is your new lucky bunny.
Perhaps this movie was just a little too big for her first role. Frances McDormand as the National Security Advisor was an excellent choice, but for the caliber actor he is, the talent of John Malkovich was a little bit squandered. There's also a couple of cameo appearances, but honestly, the one that surprised me most was Apollo 11 astronaut Buzz Aldrin. The surprise comes from the reason for his appearance. And I was glad to hear the voice of Leonard Nimoy. He voiced the character of Galvatron in the 1986 animated Transformers movie, and is back to do something in this one.
When you go to see this, be prepared for a long ride. Including trailers, your time in the theater will be almost 3 hours. I give Transformers Dark of the Moon 4.5 out of 5 tickets. Now, it's been announced that this will be the last Transformers movies for both Shia LaBeouf and Michael Bay, but no word if it's the last movie in the series. Now, next week, I'll be checking out Zookeeper, starring Kevin James and Rosario Dawson. For Fox Movie Night, I'm Mike Emery.